Hey guys, thank you for tuning in. Today's video is going to be about a step-by-step guide to drawing the equivalent circuit diagram for a single phase transformer and understanding the working of the same. Before we move on to the drawing of the equivalent circuit, here are some of the assumptions that have been considered. Number one, the transformer under consideration has losses in terms of core loss, copper loss, losses in the winding resistance and leakage reactance. Number two, the secondary of the transformer is loaded with an inductive load. And lastly, the secondary has more number of turns than primary. With these assumptions, let's begin. The difference between an ideal and a practical transformer is that a practical transformer has losses while ideal does not. So, if we draw an ideal transformer and add losses to it, it can be converted into a practical transformer. With this concept, draw an ideal transformer, which means two windings, primary and secondary. Their turns ratio is denoted as N2 by N1, which equals to K. The first loss that we are going to consider is that due to the winding resistance. It is indicated by R1 and R2. The next loss is due to leakage of magnetic flux shown by X1 and X2. Join the elements to form primary and secondary circuit. The third loss to be considered is the core loss that is depicted as a parallel resistance R0. This core loss, which is also called as iron loss, consists of hysteresis and eddy current loss. An inductor is connected in parallel with the primary winding itself. It is used to show the initial magnetizing current, which creates the magnetic flux phi in the winding. An inductive load is connected across the secondary terminal to complete the secondary circuit. Now coming to the working, when an AC supply V1 is connected across the primary side, as the primary circuit is closed, current starts flowing in the circuit. We call this current as primary current I1. This current I1 goes into the winding to create magnetic flux phi in the core. Not all of this flux is utilized completely. A small portion of the flux will link either of the windings but not both. This portion of flux is called as leakage flux. That is the amount of flux which links only one limb or leg of the transformer. The leakage current associated with the leakage flux is shown by current IW. The current which does the useful work, that is which magnetizes the core, is shown as IM. Both these currents, IW and IM, add up to give the no load current I0. The flux phi in the core set up due to the alternating current is also alternating in nature. This changing flux sets up induced EMF, also called as back EMF in the coils. EMF in coil 1 is E1 and that in coil 2 is E2. According to Lenz's law, the polarity of induced EMF in a closed loop is such that it tends to produce a current which opposes the change in the magnetic flux that produces it. So if V1 is plus minus, then E1 and E2 will be plus minus. Due to presence of R1 and X1, E1 is always lesser than V1. It is because of this that current flowing in the primary winding, that is IM, is minimum, because E1 is always opposing V1. As long as V1 is greater than E1, current will flow in the circuit. As the secondary circuit is closed with the load, current will start flowing through it. We call this current as secondary current I2. The terminal voltage drop occurring across the load is denoted as V2. And due to presence of R2 and X2, V2 is always lesser than E2. This current, which will now circulate in the winding, will create a flux phi dash of its own, which will oppose the primary flux phi. This demagnetizing effect leads to a decrease in the primary flux, which reduces the induced EMF E1. So now the source voltage V1 has an upper hand over the back EMF V1, which means the potential difference between V1 and E1 has increased, and hence V1 can now send more current in the primary circuit in the form of I2 dash. I2 dash is the reflected secondary current in the primary circuit. Hence, it is given as K times I2, where K is the transformation ratio. This current counteracts the demagnetizing effects of secondary current I2. Now, if secondary current is I2, primary current is Im plus I2 dash, which is a higher value than I2. So the flux phi also increases, and this ensures that flux in the core is maintained constant. Considering these parameters, we can write the equations for input voltage V1 and output voltage drop V2. The input voltage in the primary circuit, that is V1, has to overcome the back EMF E1 as well as the voltage drop across R1 and X1. So the equation may be written as V1 equal to E1 plus I1 into R1 plus J times X1. For the secondary circuit, E2 is the source generating the current. It has to overcome the potential drop across R2, X2 and also V2 across the load. So the equation may be written as E2 equal to V2 plus I2 into R2 plus JX2. If the terms are rearranged to write an equation for V2, we get V2 equal to E2 minus I2 times R2 plus JX2. The equation for primary current I1 is given as I1 equal to I2 dash plus I0. And that for no load current I0 is given as I0 equal to Im plus IW. To summarize the working, when supply voltage V1 is connected, a small current I1 flows to magnetize the core and create a flux phi. The changing flux phi gives rise to induced EMFs E1 and E2 on both sides of the circuit, that is primary and secondary. The secondary EMF E2 circulates I2 in the closed circuit. Presence of I2 leads to phi dash, which counters phi. A reduced phi leads to a reduced E1, which means there is a larger potential difference between V1 and E1. So I1 increases. Increased I1 means increased phi, and so the value of the flux phi is restored in the circuit. In the next video, we will draw the complete phasor diagram for the practical transformer considering all the losses. Until then, like, share and subscribe to never miss an update from Explanator, where every solution has a simple explanation.